undefeated mixed martial artist, holding a perfect professional record, 11 wins, no losses. He stands 5'8" tall, weighing in at 156 pounds, fighting out of Rabat, Morocco, Osman Bulldozer Azekar. And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Peter Hickmott.
Peter Hickmott back in there for his second assignment of the night. The beautiful Carly Baker is with us here in Abu Dhabi as the highly touted Osman Azekar makes his UFC debut against Teemu Pakalen. Azekar is in black, Pakalen is in gray. Pakalen initially drawn to wrestling and submission fighting, so certainly built his foundation with the ground game, but has really developed his striking in the time away from the octagon. No surprise to see Azekar opening up early.
We see Pakalen throwing that jab out right away, and that's how you close the distance as the shorter fighter is. As the jab gets thrown, you fire a right hand over the top, and that's what we're seeing right away.
There it is, and beautiful it lands. Counter right from Azekar. Toyo Tires, the official tire of the UFC.
You see Osman going to the body early. Leg attacks. Start beating up the body. The hands start to drop. Sets up the big headshots as the fight moves on. As we saw earlier in the matchup with Salikov.
A lot of feints out of Azekar as he attacks that lead leg of Pakalen. Oh, huge right hand. Pakalen able to eat it.
Ooh! Big shots landed when Pakalen tries to grapple him. Get a hold of that clinch. I mean, he's eating huge shots in that clinch. A
couple of nice knees there on the inside by Pakalen. Ate another big strike there from the bulldozer.
Pakalen's hurt. He's hitting him with some huge shots. He looks like his pace up. He throws a heavy pace in his first round.
Brief moment in the clinch, and now we get some separation. About 3 minutes here to go, round one. It has been all Osman Azekar thus far. And even when the guard is up, part of that right hand is finding the target.
And when you're wearing 4 ounce gloves, you don't even want to eat them on your arms, really.
Yeah.
Still gets through, shakes your head, and it sets up the next shot. Going to the body, and again, going to that clinch, ends up getting him caught with big punches. Every time he goes to that clinch, Osman just starts firing hooks and body shots, and Pakalen just seems to keep eating them.
Pakalen plus 170 as an underdog tonight. He's a Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu brown belt. You know he's going to welcome a fight on the ground tonight if he can get it there. Azekar playing to the crowd here in Abu Dhabi.
He's really comfortable. He's been able to land what he wants so far, so that makes you really comfortable knowing, all right, I can hit this guy. He's not making me miss. I've got his timing. I've got his range. And really, he's not doing anything to me yet. He hasn't been able to get the takedown, and every time he tries his offensive and the striking, being cocky, it hasn't worked. So Osman's very comfortable right now. Big right hand. He goes to the body first, sets up the overhand right, and that's the key. As a short guy, that's what you want to do, is set up that overhand right with the straight. With the straight offense, Pakalen.
Pakalen as yet unable to take Azekar down, failed on that most recent attempt. A lot of headshots already have landed for Osman Azekar.
Oh! Face first! Wow! Such a huge right hand, and he is out bad. That was one of the biggest right hands of the night, and that's the one. That's the one you got to look for following that jab. He kept sticking that jab out there, and you just got to time the right hand, and Osman finally landed it. Incredible timing.
That is one of the scariest knockouts you will ever see. Pakalen was twitching on the canvas, and the medics are attacking.
Good vibrations, good vibrations, excitation, good vibrations. how close we are. Softly smile, I know she must be kind.